few years ago, I did the F701 hack on this pen, and it's remained one of my favorite pens. It's also become a huge hit with the everyday carry community, so I wanted to do a quick video on it. Basically on background, I'll link to the blog post that explains everything below, but here's the Zebra F701. This pen sells for about $7, and it's really quite nice. It's got a knurled grip, which not a lot of pens have anymore. Metal body, metal clip, metal end piece, and it's, again, $7, so super nice. This is the Zebra F402. This is about $7 for a two-pack, and it's not quite as nice. But the funny thing about the 402 is it has a brass button assembly, whereas the F701 uses a plastic one. What someone found out was that by just with some pliers and maybe a flame or possibly a refrigerator or a freezer, depending on how you want to do it, you could remove the button mechanism from the cheap, not so great, you know, fine but not so great 402 and put it in the 701. That leaves you with this right here, which is a full metal, including the click mechanism, pen for, so if you salvage the 402 and combine it with the 701, you're looking at about $13. And then what people tend to do is put in a Fisher Space Pen cartridge, which is maybe $5. So anyway, for under $20, you have a really great everyday carry pen that is all metal and has a really nice click mechanism. Just really smooth, really solid. You'll be left with one 402, which is, you know, just a fine pen to have around. Definitely nothing wrong with it. Just not quite as nice as the 701. And definitely nice distinct click that's not muted just by the weight and the heft of the body of that 701. And just opening it up, we can see nice metal tip. I did flip the original cartridge for the Fisher Space Pen cartridge, which is pretty solid. And this is in here really well. It doesn't come out easily. If you do click through that blog post and figure out how to do this hack, I think you'll be really happy with it. It does take a little time, maybe 15 minutes with some pliers or, again, possibly some flames or freezing, depending on you, how you want to handle that. But after that, I think you will have basically the best EDC pen for the money. You could see right there, there's the thickness of that 701. It is a really nice pen, and for the money, it's pretty incredible. So yeah, that is a breakdown into why everyone uses F701s. Definitely recommend you pick one up and spend a little time doing this. Don't think you'll be disappointed.